We are going to define another data objects known as the structures. So what is the structure? So here is the detailing for it. Structured data objects, or it will be called as structures, are objects that have multiple components. The components themselves can in turn be also another structures in this way. For example, the date can be viewed as a structure with three components: day, month and year. Then the date 9th June 2017 can be written in this form. So here is the date, there is a structure name, and it is having three arguments. Structure will be having multiple arguments. So that is a main feature of structure. So here we are having this 9th June 2017. So it can be represented in this way. All structures can be represented using tree representation. So here we have this date 9 June 2017, and these three will be known as the arguments, and this is known as the functor, that is the structure name. So please remember this term, that is a functor. So prolog representation will be like this one. To represent a point, a line segment and a triangle using structure in prolog, we can consider the following statements. So point P1 can be represented using this functor point with x and y as 1, 1. So P2, that is a structure variable, can represent this point, that is a functor name, that is a functor rather, 2 and 3 are two arguments. So S, segment, obviously a segment will be connecting two points. So here we are having this P1 and P2, and P1 and P2, they are themselves are separate structures. So point 1, 1 and point 2, 3. So triangle will be having three points at its corners. So triangle can be represented using these structures. So here we have used the variable name also, that is also allowed, otherwise I can put some number there. Structures can be naturally pictured as trees. Prolog can view as a language of processing trees. So this is our structures, which are falling under the category data objects. Thanks for watching this video.